Hello everyone, welcome back to my channel Lessons at Fingertips. Here we discuss on some important topics in very simple words so that it is very easy for you all to understand and keep things in mind. So today I am back with the part 2 of my previous video, that is on e-commerce. There were certain other things which I needed to discuss with you all, but definitely the video would have been very long, much longer in the previous video. So I have made the part 2 of this video. So let's begin. So the second part implies here we are going to study some e-business risk. Whenever we are conducting the business over internet, there are certain risks, certain unavoidable risks. First one is transaction risk. You know, here three things are involved. The first one is what default on order. Okay, that is what giving and taking. What is this happening? This is actually, you know, sometimes what happens is the customer says that I have made the payment. The seller says I have not got the payment. Or maybe the seller says I have sent you the product. The customer says I have not received the product. So this is transaction risk. You know, default on order, giving and taking. There can be any kind of this transaction risk. The seller can say, I have not got the payment. The buyer will say that I have already made the payment. So how come you have not got the payment, right? So there can be this transaction risk. What is the second one? One is default in delivery. And the third one is default in payment. Okay, what is this default in delivery? Simple thing, the seller will say I have sent you the product, the buyer says I have not received the product. That is default in delivery. There can be any problem with this. Then default in payment, the same thing which we have studied here only. So this is what the default in order, giving and taking. That is the problem. Okay, someone will be giving the order, someone is taking the order, right? And there the problem has occurred. Okay, maybe the product have come, the customer have received the product and he is telling that I haven't gave the order only. I haven't ordered for this product. Why are you sending me this product? That can happen. So these are what? The transaction risk, very much important. The second one is data storage and transmission risk. What is this? You know, virus, hacking. Two very important things, very important problems which can actually occur in e-business, especially in e-business, this virus and hacking. People, see, internet is an open area, right? It's open for all. So much of cyber crimes takes place. You can't even imagine how people are going to take out all the details, your credit card details, your transaction details, some secret, secret policies or secret stuffs about your company. So everything people can easily bring it out, isn't it? Because cyber crimes are increasing day by day. So that is the thing is happening here. There is data storage, the data of your company, the data of your transaction, everything can easily be taken out, can easily be transmitted. So there is a risk, data storage and transmission risk. The third one, very important one, risk to intellectual property and privacy. In this, we have the five elements. These are what? Elements. The elements in risk to intellectual property and privacy. First is authenticity. Authentic transaction, taking place of authentic transaction, the one which we have studied here, that a consumer will say, yes, I have ordered for this product. The producer will, or the seller will say, yes, I have got the order for your product. This is an authentic transaction. If the seller is delivering you the product and the buyer says, I haven't even given the order only, why are you sending me the product? Isn't it? Or here the customer is telling that I have ordered for this product, but I haven't received it. But the seller says I haven't received it. So how am I going to deliver it to you? Authentic transaction is not taking place. That is authenticity. Intrigity. What is intrigity? It's trust. Trust between the sellers as well as the customers. trust in transactions. The sellers is trusting the consumers and telling, yes, you have ordered for this product, I am going to deliver it to you. That is the trust. The third one is confidentiality. Confidentiality is maintaining the secrecy of the data, okay, the transactions. That is confidentiality. The fourth one is non-reputability of origin. One is origin, one is receipt. What is origin? The customer's giving order is the non-reputability of origin. The customers will not say, listen to what I am saying, will not say that I have not given order for this product. If the customers have given order for a product, they will say that, yes, I have given order for this product. And this is non-reputability of receipt. That is, the seller is not going to tell you that I haven't received the order for your product. If they have received the order, they are going to say that I have received the order for your product and I am going to deliver it to you. So this was what the e-business risk, the risk which are involved in the e-business. These are not the disadvantages. These are certain risks that can be present, that is actually present in e-business while conducting electronic business, while conducting the business over internet. The businessman, the seller can actually go through these kind of risk involved, which are involved in conducting the e-business. Here in the second part, we are going to discuss two more important things, threats to e-business. We have already read this risk thing, but what are the threats to e-business? The first one is hacking. In the risk itself, we have read there is a risk of the website getting hacked, or the company's website getting hacked, and they can just steal your data and everything. So there is a problem of hacking. There is a threat of being the website being hacked, okay, and then misused. Okay, so the next thing is brand hijacking. What is brand hijacking? You will see that sometimes these big brands like Amazon or maybe Flipkart, they were initially performing. Okay, the second thing is brand hijacking. What happens is that sometimes you will see the big brands like Amazon or Flipkart, they were initially performing this buying and selling of products in their website, right? But then they are entering into the, especially Amazon, all of a sudden overnight stardom, you can call it overnight stardom. Amazon started this reading of books, the site where you can go and read the books, but already in the market there were other those sites where you can actually go and read the book. So those are sites, Amazon, because it already have a big brand name, it overthrew all those well-known brands which from a long time existed, and they were performing very hard to get the position, but Amazon all of a sudden came and take away the position. Especially you can see the Amazon Pay, now it have come. Already there is Paytm, Google Pay, PayPal, which were present, whose function is itself to make the payments online, right? But all of a sudden Amazon Pay have come and they are saying that you can pay using this. So the people who are already using the Amazon app, or we are the subscribers, who are the subscribers, they will prefer to pay through Amazon Pay itself. But it's not, work was not like that, isn't it? So that is what brand hijacking, using the brand name, they are getting into other fields, other departments also, which is actually not theirs. Then is impersonation. What is that? Sometimes what happens in case of e-business, because there is lack of personal touch, another fake person can actually claim to be the customer. Okay, suppose they have got some kisika credit card from somewhere, they have stolen it. They can actually say that I am this person and make the payment using that credit card, right? That is impersonation. The seller is not going to see his or her face, neither the seller recognizes the person. So there can be impersonation. Then is the viruses. Yes, computer, the website can be have a great threat from the viruses, okay? It can actually destroy the data, it can destroy the website. So for that, what do you need? Antivirus. Then fraudulent trading. What is fraudulent trading? This fraud activity, someone like the impersonation, someone can say I have made the payment, and they can just, you know, sometimes what happens is the buyer will tell that the payment is been, I have made the payment, the money has been deducted from my account. They can show you a message. There are so many types of people, you can't even imagine. People can do so lot of fraudulent activities. Okay, they will show the seller that the payment has been made, or maybe the seller will even get a message the payment has been made, but the money won't be transferred to his bank account. So these kind of fraudulent activities can take place. Okay, so these are the threats in e-business, especially over the internet. You know, you cannot actually trace the frauds which are taking place easily. You cannot trace it easily unless and until you are an expert in that. Okay, we have read earlier in the first part of this video, you remember, I hope you guys remember that we have mentioned there you know, not very well acquainted with internet, right? Not very well acquainted, unfamiliarity. So that is the thing. If you are not an expert, if you have not even hired an expert to control all these websites over the internet, then you are going to face a great problem, man. Then the second thing is methods to ensure safety. Yes, there should be, there are so many threats, risk. There should be definitely some method to ensure the risk, to ensure the threat, to ensure safety. What is it? Cyber crime cells. Yes, do register in the cyber crime cells. Do tell them, take the help of the cyber crime cells. If you are facing some kind of problem like this, then is encryption. What is encryption? It's what the transactions which are taking place, the data which is stored, transfer, encrypt it in form of code, because codes are not easily, it cannot be easily hacked. Okay, so you can encrypt it, you can change it to code, the data, the transactions, that is encryptions. Digital signatures, use digital signatures. It's not easy to copy, it's not easy to hack it or use it in some other transactions. So easy, do use digital signatures. Then the fourth one is third party involved. What is this? If you are seller and a buyer, these two other persons party involved in a transaction. Now if you involve a third party, what will the seller do if a transaction is been made? If a buyer is paying and the seller says I have not got the payment, then buyer can involve a third party. He can send them he can already send the message to that person and tell that I have made the payment, keep this in your in your data, keep it as a data. And then if the seller says that I haven't got the payment, received the payment, the third party can be involved to show that yes, the payment has been done. So that's how you can do with third party. So let us just recall everything we have read: the risk involved in e-business, the threats to e-business, and the methods to ensure the e-business, the safety in the e-business. So this was all about part 2. I hope you guys have liked this video. Please do subscribe to my channel and like this video if you have liked it. Bye bye.